Gregory Yefimovich Rasputin was born to a peasant family in Siberia on January 10, 1869. His family owned the land which they worked, but they still had difficulties when it came to regular survival. His mother birthed many children, but not all survived.
There was an extreme turning point in Rasputin's life when he was 8 years old that brought about a fierce depression. It was the death of his older brother, Dmitri. One day when the boys were swimming, his brother nearly drowned in the river and then later died of pneumonia. Rasputin was haunted by this event and he abruptly changed after it. It was a point that marked the development of his newly found mystical powers.
Rasputin could allegedly read minds and cure animals with just the touch of his hand. On one instance, when he was young, he came out into a meeting of older men who were discussing a robbery. Rasputin was able to point out the perpetrator. Even though those men did not believe him, they later found out that what Rasputin had said was true. That helped kick off his reputation as a starets.
He was sexually active at a young age, but he finally settled down with a woman called Praskovia, who refused his sexual advances before matrimony.
Rasputin partook in many adultering activities in which he had intercourse with younger women. The women denied the allegations, but they were usually true. Rasputin's wife, Praskovia, accepted his adultery as the cross he had to carry in life.
Gregory was highly disliked by the people in his town because of his abundant drinking and unholy activities. To settle the uproar his actions had caused, Rasputin left town to go on a pilgrimage. On trips like this, he learned how to take advantage of people to help him advance his social status.
On his trips, he observed their religious activities, which helped him in trying to become a more spiritual man. He would hold his own ceremonies in which he spoke of teachings. His religious activities also raised questions because they believed he was part of a clist group. A clist is a religious group which takes part in sexual rites.
Rasputin came into the life of the Tsar when his son Alexei suffered a terrible hemophilic attack. His health was very important to all since he was the only heir to the throne. The holy man was the only one who could ease the pain, so they decided that they would just keep him around. Rasputin's presence near the royal family was unknown to regular citizens, so rumors arose about the peasant in the castle.
When Tsar Nicholas went to defend the front, he left his wife in charge, but rumors circulated that Alexandra was heavily influenced by Rasputin. He was always ready to offer his opinion and advice on any political situation. His loudmouth got him into trouble amongst many nobles, and hatred for Rasputin spread amongst citizens and nobility.
Felix Yusupov invited Rasputin over to dinner in order to commit the murder. They lured Rasputin into the castle by telling him that he would be able to have intercourse with Irina, so obviously he agreed. She was supposed to meet Rasputin in the basement after the guests were gone. They served Rasputin cyanide-coated pastries and wine, which is supposed to kill him, but neither worked. Felix shot him, but Gregory was still able to stagger off. Then Vladimir shot him, and Rasputin collapsed. They then threw him in a body of water, where he finally drowned.
Gregory Rasputin, a wandering peasant who set a huge influence on the Tsar and Tsarina, was and still is one of the most peculiar and mysterious people of Russian history and will always remain.